So we are talking about current affairs from 8th to 20th November, topic wise. The next topic that we have to cover is benefits and concerns of Aadhaar. This is important for phase 1, phase 2 ESI, and also for the English essay writing that will happen in phase 2. So there might be a topic, there might be an essay on benefits and concerns of Aadhaar as well. And therefore, this topic becomes very, very important. So what are the benefits, expected benefits out of Aadhaar? The benefits, expected benefits are, number one, clean out duplication and fake transactions or fake IDs. Presently what happens is one person can create different IDs or can create IDs on different names. For example, if his name is, let's say, Sushil Kumar, he can go and create one more on the name of Sushil by just putting an H between S and U. So he's creating different identities. The same person is using different identities and that results in duplication. Similarly, there can be fake identities also, and Aadhaar results in cleaning out of duplication and fake IDs because it is linked with biometric of every person. So one person cannot have two biometrics, and therefore he cannot create two identities. Number two, enabling implementation of direct benefit programs. So direct benefit programs are linked with banks, and banks, by linking with UIDAI, are ensuring that no fake bank accounts are being created. So one particular person can create multiple bank accounts in different banks, but if his bank accounts are linked with biometric, then all his bank accounts will automatically be linked. Therefore, it will result in more efficient and more effective direct benefit program. Third is reduction in cost of identifying persons. So presently there is certain cost attached with identifying every person in the country. That cost of identifying person reduces with the incoming of Aadhaar. Next is more transparency in government implementation, because there is a lot of corruption that results in discretion in the hands of authorities, and that results in intransparent government implementation programs. So with the incoming of UIDAI, the government implementation will become more transparent. Let's take an example to understand this. For example, the government is implementing PDS, and for this, let's say these are the three people who have been identified. Now what government authorities might do is create artificial persons who are actually not in existence. They actually don't exist, and give out PDS to these five people. Say that they are giving out PDS to these five people, but in effect they are only giving out PDS to these three people, and these two citizens do not exist and exist only on paper. They do not exist in reality. This will be eliminated because every person's identity is verified with the help of biometric, and every person is provided a unique identity, and therefore these two people will automatically be eliminated, because if biometric of these people clashes with biometric of any other person, then these two biometrics are going to come into clash with each other, and therefore the government will be able to identify that there is actually fake UIDAI being created, fake Aadhaar card being created. Now what are the concerns attached with the Aadhaar? Number one, data hacking. So there's a big concern of hacking of data, because if the entire data of every citizen in the country is available with one organization and it is hacked by terrorist organizations or some other illegal entities, then that might cause a lot of problem for the country. Absence of redressal mechanism in case of a hack. So there is no official redressal mechanism in place at present, and therefore that is a big issue that is a big concern for users. Absence of a right to determine which services to be linked with Aadhaar, and how can agencies use your personal information. So this is a big concern, because right now there is no law or there is no rule as to which services are to be linked with Aadhaar and how can agencies actually use your personal information. So if these agencies are using your personal information for marketing purposes, then actually that is considered to be an illegal activity. That should be considered to be an illegal activity, and that should not be allowed. Usage by third parties. Reliance Jio using biometrics to check people's identity. So presently there is no ban on usage of biometrics by third parties, and there should be proper regulation so that these companies are not able to sell or not able to misuse this data that they are going to gather in terms of biometrics as well as Aadhaar card numbers. So this is about benefits and concerns of Aadhaar. If there is an essay, then these 8-9 points should be more than enough. If you are able to provide the reader with these 8-9 very good and hardcore concepts points, you should be able to get good marks.